गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कवर आवर टॉपिक ऑफ फैक्टर अफेक्टिंग डिमांड। इन अ प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट द लॉ ऑफ डिमांड। नेक्स्ट, डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ डिमांड। डिमांड मीन्स डिजायर ऑफ अ पर्सन, डिजायर ऑफ अ कंज्यूमर टू बाय अ कमोडिटी, हैविंग अ सफिशिएंट परचेजिंग पावर एंड विलिंगनेस टू स्पेंड। सपोज यू हैव अ डिजायर टू बाय अ car, but if you don't have a money to buy it, then desire will become only a want, then it will not called demand. When you have enough money to buy a car, then it become demand. There is a difference in a desire and a want. Suppose you want to buy a car but you don't have a money, then it become a desire. But on the other hand, if you have a money to buy a car, then it becomes demand. So this is a difference. Next is demand and quantity demanded. The term demand refers to various quantities which are preferred by a consumer at a different prices, but term quantity demanded refers to specific quantity purchased by a consumer at a specific price of a commodity. So there is a difference in a demand and a quantity demanded. Demand refers to various quantities of demand at different prices which consumer ready to buy. But quantity demanded refers to a specific quantity which a consumer want to buy at a specific price. Suppose consumer demand is a 2 ice cream when the price was rupees 15, and when the price was rupees 10, its consumer demand rises to 4. There is an inverse relationship between a demand and a price of a commodity. When a price of a commodity is less, then demand of that commodity is more. If the price is a more of a commodity, then demand for that commodity will be a less. Next, factors affecting demand, or it also called determinants of demand. And first factor is price of a commodity. We are already studied about the law of demand. In a law of demand, there is only variation in a price and all other factors remain constant, and there is an inverse relationship between a demand and price. When the price of a commodity goes up, then demand quantity demanded goes down, and when the price goes down, then the quantity demanded goes up. So there is a relation between price of a commodity and the demand of the commodity. There is an inverse relationship. When the price increases, demand decreases, and when the price decreases, demand increases, and price increases and demand decreases. Next factor is price of related good. Price of related good means when there is a change in a price of a related good, then demand of the commodity is also influenced by the change in the price of the related goods. There are two types of goods: substitute goods and complementary goods. Substitute goods are those goods which are substituted for each other. For instance, tea and coffee. If the price of a tea increases, then the demand of coffee increases. And if the price of the tea decreases, then the demand of a coffee increases. On the other hand, if the price of the tea decreases, then the demand of the coffee also increases. There is a direct relation between the prices of the substitute goods. For instance, if the price of Coca-Cola drops, then the demand goes up of the Pepsi. Similarly, if the price of a Coca-Cola goes drop down, then the demand of a Pepsi increases in the market. Next is complementary goods. Complementary goods are those goods which are jointly used. For instance, tar and petrol. If the price of a petrol increases, then the demand of car decreases. Similarly, if the price of petrol decreases, then the demand of petrol car increases. So in a complementary goods, there is an example of car and petrol. If price of petrol increases, then the demand of car decreases. If the price of a petrol goes down, then the demand of petrol cars increases. So there is a inverse relation. Next factor is the income of the consumer. If the income of the consumer increases, their tendency to buy of a commodity also increases. When the income of the consumer increases, they want to buy more and more, and when their income falls, they buy less. For instance, when the income of the consumer is less, they demand only for the inferior goods. But when their income increases, their demand increases for the superior goods. For instance, if we wear local clothes, but when the income of increases, when income of the consumer increases, then we want to buy a branded clothes. So there is a impact of the there is an impact on the demand by the income of the consumer. Next factor is expectation of a consumer. If consumer expect that price in a future will rise, then he will ready to buy at a present price, and he stock the commodity at a present price for the future use. Similarly, if he hope that price in a future will fall, then he buy less at a present price in present time. So when consumer expect fall in a price in a future, they spend less money on a commodity. When they expect price will be more in a future, then they buy more and more quantity at a present price. Next factor is taste and preferences. Taste and preferences include fashion custom, and taste preferences are influenced by the advertisement, change in fashion, climate, and new invention. For instance, iPhone launched a new model, then by people or customer influenced by the advertisement, because in advertisement they provide information about the new features. In this way, they have an impact on a demand. Next is population size. Demand increases with increase in the population and decreases with decrease in the population. If, for instance, male population demand more for the cosmetics, on the other hand, male population demand for the phones or machinery or equipments. So there is a difference in the demand of the female as well as in the male population. So these are the factors which affect the demand. Now I summarize briefly these factors. First is price of a commodity. When a price of a commodity increases, their demand decreases. And when the price goes down, then their demand goes up. Next is factories, price of related good. Under this, there are two types of goods, substitute goods and complementary goods. Substitute goods are those goods which are substitute for each other. For instance, tea and coffee. If the price of a tea increases, then the demand of a coffee increases. If the price of a tea decreases, then demand of coffee decreases. Next is a complementary goods. Complementary goods are those goods which complete the demand for each other. For instance, car and petrol. if the price of a petrol increases, then the demand for petrol car decreases. If the price of petrol decreases, then demand for petrol car increases. Next is income of the consumer. There is a direct relationship between the income and demand of the commodity. If the income of the consumer increases, then their demand for the commodity also increases. For instance, when the income is low, consumer consume only inferior goods, but when their income rises, they started to consume superior goods. For instance, when their income is low, they prefer to wear local clothes, but when their income is rises, then they prefer to branded clothes. Next one is expectation. If a consumer expect rise in a price in a future, then he will buy more quantity at in a present time. And if they expect fall in a price in a future, then they buy less quantity at a present price in a present time. Next one is taste and preferences. Taste and preferences also has a direct impact on a demand of a commodity. Taste and preferences include fashion, custom, and these are influenced by the advertisement, change in fashion, climate, and new invention. Next one is population size. There is also a direct relation between demand and the population size. If the population size is more, then demand also increases. And if the population size decreases, then there is a decrease in the demand. So these are the factors of demand, which, or it is also called determinants of demand.